Welcome to Get Fitness Success, where we learn about our body, mind, and spirit. This video does not replace expert medical advice. Ask a doctor if you have any questions. Please subscribe, like, and comment. I appreciate your support. In this video, we will learn about the prefrontal cortex, what it is, what it does, and how you can improve its function with easy and fun exercises. Let's begin. You have heard it said, use it or lose it. Well, the prefrontal cortex is no different. We frequently overlook the fact that our brains, like our bodies, require exercise in order to be healthy and function well for extended periods of time. The value of mental fitness is comparable to that of physical fitness. The human brain is considered the command center of the nervous system. Our brains, no matter how complex they appear, share the same basic structure as other mammal brains. The main distinction is that it is larger in relation to body size than any other brain. Humans also have the largest frontal lobes of any animal. The cerebrum, which is divided into two hemispheres, takes up the majority of the space. The brainstem is located beneath the surface, and the cerebellum is located behind it. The cerebral cortex is the hemisphere's outermost layer, consisting of four lobes: the frontal lobe or prefrontal cortex, the parietal lobe, the temporal lobe, and the occipital lobe. This 3-pound organ controls all bodily functions and interprets external information. To name a few, our brains control intelligence, creativity, performance, emotion, and memory. The frontal lobe is responsible for our consciousness, as well as activities that appear human-like, such as the languages we speak. Here are a few of the many additional functions of our frontal lobe: personality, behavior and emotions, making decisions, planning, problem solving, speaking and writing, physical movement, intelligence, attention, and self-awareness are all functions of the frontal lobe. Phineas Gage, a railroad worker, suffered one of the most well-known frontal lobe injuries. He survived after a railroad spike punctured a piece of his frontal lobe. He survived, but he lost his eye, as well as much of his personality. Gage's case, on the other hand, exemplifies a broader understanding of the brain. It demonstrates that our understanding of it is constantly evolving. As a result, it is impossible to predict the outcome of any specific frontal lobe injury, and comparable injuries may manifest in very different ways in different people. Even if the majority of us are not injured, our brains all change as we age. As a result, mental function improves, but mental health decline is common, and it is one of the most feared side effects of aging. Cognitive decline, on the other hand, is avoidable. Brain exercises are advised on a regular basis. The more this extremely intelligent organ is put to the test, the more it will learn and evolve. As a result, it will remain active and valuable. The frontal lobe and the hippocampus play critical roles in learning, memory, and other complex mental functions. Here are 7 daily prefrontal cortex exercises to keep your brain young and active. Number 1. Memory card game. This is the same memory game we used to play as kids. We had to match pairs of buses, vehicles, fruits, vegetables, and other objects from a stack of jumbled and neatly arranged cards, and we had to rely solely on our memory to do so. That's an excellent mental workout. You don't have to have a special memory card deck. You can use a pack of regular playing cards. Instead of matching vehicles and fruits, just match reds and blacks. Number 2. Math flashcards. Play with simple math exercises and set yourself goals as you progress. To get back to basics, start with counting tables or flashcards. Number 3. Brain training apps. We've all heard of Sudoku and Minesweeper, two excellent brain training games. But, since we live in a digital age, let us make the most of it. Brain training games include Memory, Smart Unites, and MindSync. These apps work best with EEG sensors like the Sensiband. Number 4. Have some fun with words. Crossword puzzles, find a word puzzles, and Scrabble are enjoyable games to play. Another common method for recalling words is mnemonics, which is a practice in which you try to connect a group of words by phrases in order to remember them better. Number 5. Food's power. Do you like to cook? it's possible that you already know more than those who don't. Cooking is one of those skills that necessitates the use of all of your senses in order to create the perfect meal: smell, sight, taste, touch, and sound. As a result, it's an excellent mental workout. Number 6. It's time to work on a puzzle. Clear off the table and make room for the puzzle pieces. Try your hand at jigsaw puzzles. It's a good brain exercise because it improves hand-eye coordination while also being entertaining. Number 7. Happiness is the key to success. Anger leads to delusion, and delusion leads to memory confusion. Fear, despair, self-pity, envy, grief, hatred, restlessness, and anxiety are just a few examples of negative emotions that can cloud your judgment. While this mist hangs over your mind, your senses can become dulled to the point where you don't notice even your immediate surroundings or experiences. It is therefore critical to keep a positive attitude because it will help your brain work better. So go for a run, a hike, a dance, a meditation, or whatever else makes you happy to release those happy chemicals. From children to the elderly, the right neurotechnology allows you to go above and beyond. Cognitive functions are useful in everyday life, especially in school. Higher processing skills, such as attention and memory, aid in areas that require a high level of logical processing, such as math. Do you want to live a happier and healthier life as an elderly person? Around the age of 25, our cognitive abilities begin to deteriorate. Despite the fact that this is a normal part of getting older, it should not be dismissed as such. Brain training can help to prevent cognitive decline, which can lead to mental illnesses. If you have made it this far, please hit the like and subscribe buttons. Now, go get fit.